Hello friends, welcome to the yoga show once again by Rishi. Well, today I am going to explain you how exactly to do a Dhanurasana, which is also known as a bow pose, okay? So why it is called as a bow pose? Because Dhanurasana, Dhanush means in Sanskrit, when we translate in English, it is called as bow. And whereas asana means it is called as pose or a posture. Therefore, Dhanurasana is called as a bow pose or a bow posture. Okay, so now I'm going to explain you how exactly to do a Dhanurasana and what exactly are its benefits. Okay, so initially what you are going to do is you are going to lay down your body, okay, in this way. Okay, so lay down your body completely initially in this way. Okay, now what you need to do is you need to get your two legs in a comfortable distance. Do not, that distance has to be comfortable. It shouldn't be too near like this. Okay, it should be comfortable. Now what you need to do is the inner thighs, okay, the inner thighs has to be rotated inside. Okay, inner thighs has to be rotated inside like this. Okay, it shouldn't be like this. Okay, it should be rotated inside. Okay, or it should be rolled inside like this. Okay, now what you need to do is you got to bend your knees in this way. Okay, bend your knees, and now you need to inhale slowly and try to catch your ankles, okay, like this initially. So like this initially. So this is not Dhanurasana, this is the initial part of the Dhanurasana. Okay, so what exactly you need to do is now you got to inhale. When you're trying to inhale, you have to raise your legs, okay, then exhale and try to hold your legs, okay, again then inhale, then try to raise your legs to the maximum level, then try to exhale and hold your ankles. Okay, so try to inhale slowly by looking in upper direction like this. Try to raise your legs, okay, try to raise your legs, exhale, hold on. Now try to inhale again and raise your legs. Exhale, hold on. Okay, now try to again inhale and raise your legs. Exhale. Okay, now have a normal breath. Now what exactly you need to do is, what exactly has to happen is the whole weight of the body will be resting on abdominal region, and the pelvis region, the only pelvis region and stomach region will touch the floor, and the remaining part will be in upper direction. Okay, now get back to original position. I can get back to Makarasana. When you're dropping down, you have to exhale, okay? So what exactly you are going to do in Dhanurasana is, just like when you are going to tie two ropes, okay? When you are going to tie two ropes and you are pulling back in opposite direction, okay? And the tension creates in between that, okay? It is nothing but you are testing the strength of your arm, or your strength of your arms and strength of your muscles of your legs, okay? Or you can say you're trying to balance, or you can, or you're trying to strengthen your muscles or your legs. At the same time, you're trying to strengthen your arms, okay? By creating a tension or by creating a force between them. That is nothing but the abdomen region, okay? So that's the other way of concept, okay? So let's do it again. The concept is, you have to inhale slowly, raise your legs, then exhale, try to hold on, then inhale, then try to exhale, try to raise your legs as much as possible you can, then exhale, hold down and try to hold it for 15 to 20 seconds, okay, 15 to 20 seconds, then try to exhale slowly and get back to original position, okay. Now once there is a consistency in practice, we can do it for minimum 30 seconds to 1 minute, okay. So let's do it again. So make sure your legs are at a comfortable distance such that the inner thighs are rolled inside with a comfortable distance, okay. Now try to inhale, raise your neck region, raise your head region into the sky, not totally exactly into the sky but into the direction of the sky, okay. Inhalation. Inhale, okay, then exhale, inhale, raise like this, raise your bar, you are exhaling and holding. Now try to again inhale and raise your legs, raise your head, okay, make sure that the whole weight is on the abdomen region and only stomach and pelvis region is on the floor. Now try to hold 15 to 20 seconds. Now exhale. Get into the Makrasana position. Try to have a normal breath for at least 30 seconds. So this is how you got to do the Dhanurasana, okay. Always any asana in yoga, if you do it perfectly, I am sure that you are going to burn your calories to the maximum. You are going to sweat it out, okay. You can see my sweat once again. So what exactly are the benefits of the Dhanurasana? Well, actually the major benefits for the Dhanurasana are, it actually cures the constipation, it increases the functionality of pancreas region, pancreas organ, thereby increasing the functional, benefiting the diabetes, okay, and it improves or it activates, or you can say it stretches, it strengthens your internal organs of the abdomen region, thereby increasing the digestion, thereby the efficiency of the digestion of your body will be get increased, your ankles get stronger, your ankles get strengthened, okay, your arms get strengthened, your muscles of your legs get strengthened, and your thighs get strengthened, and moreover the fat of your thigh will decrease or will get reduced, thereby it reduces your weight of the body, okay. The thing is, the breathing is crucial in this. You have to inhale when you are trying to raise your legs, okay, then try to exhale and hold on, okay, hold on for 15 to 20 seconds, okay. It's not necessary that you need to raise your legs to certain level, okay. Initially you can go for the first lower level, then middle level, then higher level, okay. That's the thing, you cannot do it in one fortnight, okay. So let us do it again, the Dhanurasana, okay. Lay down your body, rest your body in this way, put your legs together with a comfortable distance such that the inner region, or you can say the inner thighs, should be at a comfortable distance and should be rolled, okay, it should be rolled. And now try to bend your knees, inhale, hold on, exhale, inhale, raise your, exhale in this way, try to lift your head and feel the energy in your, from your nose to the bottom abdomen region.
Exhale and drop down. Go for your Makarasana.
So this is how you got to do the Dhanurasana. Okay? Hope you have enjoyed this video and hope you have understood the concept of the Dhanurasana. Okay? Concentrate well and practice well as much as possible you can. Okay? So meet you in the next video. For now, Namaste.